Today the weather was really bad, but I'm happy that some of you could come. That's so your integrity and your tenacity to come here and how much you enjoy being in the temple. Our Sunday service, I always emphasize, not just only the talk, it's a total spending of the time in the shrine and trying to feel closer to the divine, closer to our own soul or Atman. And as the reading of the songs or being together with the devotees and mingling with them and talking nice things, all it gives us some energy for whole week. I remember how the devotees used to say, coming from far away from Belleville and went away, and Monday when they go to office, they say, what happened? How we are so energetic on Monday? We are all feel like, oh, again the Monday came and again we have to come work. We feel dejected on Mondays. But you seem to be very fresh and welcoming. So where do you go on Sunday? Where do you go on Sunday that you have so much energy to come on Monday? So the devotees used to come here, and that was their praising, but how they feel energy when they come all the way driving 2 hours, 2.5 hours to Toronto from Belleville, and going back 2.5 hours. So that's the importance of coming today. Really, those who could come today are really brave. The roads are very icy and slippery, and there have been warning all over that please do not go out of your home unless it is very necessary. So those who could come, they felt it. Going to the temple is really very necessary for me. So we are very close to Christmas, the birth of Jesus of 25th December. So we choose a topic on Jesus. Jesus is the way. In fact, Jesus is the way is from the what Jesus said, I am the way. Jesus said, I am the way and truth and life. So these are the very important words Jesus said just before he knew that he was going to in his life, in his mission in this world. Just one day before he was going to be betrayed and crucified, that he had said. Then he said, that day he gave so fantastic things that how he is an incarnation. If you read the John, Gospel of John on that day, chapter 13, chapter 14 of John, you'll find how he says, relates himself with God. He said, those who have seen me have seen Father in heaven. So I and Father in heaven, it says somewhere else, but that is the message that Jesus gives, that he and God, those who have seen me, have seen Father. When I speak, I don't speak of myself. It's Father speaking through me, Father that dwells in me. So that is the concept that Jesus is the incarnation of God, not only Son of God. That was said because, you know, the Judaism, as it is, they can say God incarnate. That would be too much for them to understand that. So in a lighter way, too, so that they understand that way, that someone, God's own Son or the only Son has come. In that way, by saying that, they can relate. If say, I am the God born, so it will be blasphemous. So it will be sin according to that religion. God cannot be born, God cannot be seen. But God can be seen. That's what the Jesus is. He can become man. He can become everything. He has become this whole universe. He can become everything. And when he comes as incarnation, he comes with all his power and glory. And that is seen the way he guides. The most important thing when God comes to the world is to guide human beings. The guru aspect of God, Satchidananda is the only guru. When Jesus said, I am the way. He says, the way, because he is the God present at that time. So, Sri Krishna says that, I am born from time to time. Whenever there is need, I project myself. So, but Jesus here says, the way. Similar thing they asked. He said that, I am the way and the truth and life. And they said, I will be going soon and you will follow me. Where I am going, you cannot follow now, but you will follow later. So where he was going, people didn't know. But Jesus knows where he is going, what is the future, what is the mission of his life, when it, all this as Swami Vivekananda had known when his mission will come to an end and then he will give up this body. Jesus also knew that his mission has come to an end. All this betrayal, according to one theory, all this betrayal and all those things are just the drama enacted. Jesus knew everything. Everything that he is going to be betrayed because his mission is finished. He has given the message. That great message that God wanted to deliver in the form of Jesus has been given. And that message will roll on through his disciples who had picked up. And they have infused his power. Otherwise, who are the disciples? The fishermen, the traders, the money changers, those are the disciples. How could they do those great work that the Christianity came forth and surviving and increasing in his strength and glory? All this is the power of God that is infused in them. So this is the Jesus power of God that is coming. So he said, he asked, where I am going, you cannot follow me, but you will follow later. Then he said, you know the way to the place where I am going? He asked them. Then Thomas said, we don't know where you are going, and how will we know where the way you are going through? So neither we know the way nor what you are saying you are going. So he didn't say where he is going, people didn't think anything, they couldn't foresee the incidents. So that time he had said that, I am the way and the truth and life. Similar incident is found in Gita also. So when Jesus also said, at one place he said, I am. This I am is a very great thing. In fact, in our Vedantic this thing, always to say I am. This I is always am. It is never changing. It is never was. It is never will be. It is always permanent am. It is ever existing reality is I. That Atma ever abides, ever exists. That is the thing. Jesus also said, I am. It means I myself. Only I am. That every soul is that. Jesus knows because he is God incarnate. We are ignorant, that's why we don't know. That is different between the great holy persons who have realized God and us. They have realized, we have not yet realized. But the same reality exists in us. He says, truly, truly, I say, before Abraham was, I am. That I am factor is there. Similar thing just you see in the Gita, which was much before Jesus Christ. And there also, Sri Krishna says in the fourth chapter, that the knowledge of yoga I had taught to Vivaswan, and Vivaswan and imparted that to Manu, and then Manu to Ikshvaku, like that. Then Arjuna heard this, and Arjuna said, Krishna, you are saying that you taught it to Vivaswan. Vivaswan was born much earlier. You born just yesterday, just in my time. How could you teach Vivaswan? There he says, Sri Krishna says, Arjuna, you and I have been gone through many lives. I remember them all. He remembered not. That's what Jesus says here in a different, in the Vedantic way, that even before Abraham was, Abraham is the first man, first created human being according to the Bible. And before Abraham was, I am. Not that I was, that I am continues. I am is always there. That's why I am the way. I am the truth. I am life. That I am factor is there. They say in the Bible there are seven instances where Jesus says, I am. Seven quotes. So Jesus is, said the incarnate, in fact Jesus said, John said that Jesus, the incarnate word of God. So not exactly the God's incarnation in human form, but John said in the Bible it is there, Jesus is the incarnation of the word of God. And what is word? The God himself said in the Bible it is there, before anything that there was the word, and word became flesh. And that word was with God, and God was the word. And here it says, Jesus is the incarnate God. This very word is there in the Bible, John says. So Jesus is definitely incarnation of God. Nothing less than that. Nothing that Son and Father is there, Son and Father relationship. As Jesus said, Son is the Father reborn. Son is the Father being seen in the form of Son. That's clearly said. And he said, what about the life? He said, I am way, about way we'll talk a little later. I am the truth means which always abides, which always is there, which is never changing, that Jesus is, that God is, who can be always present, that I am, is only God. And then, I am life. Why Jesus says life? He also says that, you see, the whole life depends on God, and we are eternal life. Jesus promises them in the way that they can understand. They say, my father, there are many mansions in the house of my father, Father in heaven. So it means that there is a place for everyone. He says, I go there and make place for you, so that you follow me. That type of thing he explains. That means, I have come here to guide you to the place of heaven, the paradise, the ultimate reality, to close to God or to God. That to say that way, explaining that way, he says, I am going and I will make their place for you to go. That's what Jesus said. Because, then he says, because I leave, you also leave. Because that's what the Vedanta says. Now these teachings of the Bible and Vedanta can be just compared and found. How do we leave? The very Upanishad says, if there was no joy, there was no bliss, why the people will breathe at all? If there was no ananda, ediva ananda nasyat, kohe vanyat, ka pranyat, eda heve ananda nasyat. Who would have lived, who would have breathed, if there was no ananda? And that ananda is satchidananda, the bliss. That bliss is there, the God is there, that's why whole existence is there. We live because there is God. That God lives in us as our own soul or God one. So Jesus is life eternal. He promises that, eternal life. And that's what means by I am life. I am life. Because He is the life eternal. God is life eternal. If there is no God, there can be no existence at all. So whole existence depends on God. So Jesus said, I am life, I live, and that's why you live. If there is no God, there is no existence. Who created this universe? Is God created. From what He created? Out of Himself is created. Why out of Himself? Because nothing exists but God. His whole existence is one. That's the concept of Vedanta. When He says, the one reality that exists is Brahman. That is the concept of Advaita Vedanta, non-dual Vedanta. This thing that God, now the way, the thing, I am the way, Jesus is the way. So Jesus here says, as the Vedanta explains, Jesus, when He says, I am the way, when Swami Vivekananda says, I am the ocean of which Jesus and the Buddha, the Christ and the Buddha are just waves, who is that I? When Jesus says, I am the way, who is that I? Is that the person or the being that is contained in the person? Jesus, if we see the Jesus as that person who is born in that time, exists in that, lives in that time and that one, then it will be misunderstanding. Whenever Sri Krishna says in the Gita that I have imparted this, I say to you, that's always that I is that supreme being, that Brahman, that supreme God. They always identify with God. When Swami Vivekananda says, I am the ocean, that's not the Vivekananda, the man we see. The Vivekananda, the real Vivekananda, the Atman Vivekananda, which is infinite. That is the ocean. At that time they identify with the whole Supreme Being and say, I am the vast, infinite ocean, and whatever happens in this world is just a wave. The moons and the sun and the planets and the oceans and galaxies are just the waves. Galaxies are the bigger waves, there are the smaller waves, and the persons and the great personalities, God, those who come, are just the waves. The incarnation of God are the waves. Ocean is formless, infinite, not seen, and when it comes the waves, then comes, you can see the wave, you can feel the wave. In one song for Sri Ramakrishna also it says, Arupo Shaire Leela Lahari. There is an infinite ocean of without form. On that came a breeze of mercy, and on that came, through the breeze of mercy, the waves came. And that wave is Sri Ramakrishna. So Sri Ramakrishna is that infinite ocean, formless. On that formless ocean comes a breeze of mercy, a feeling for the humanity, feeling for its own creation. And then the ocean takes a form. And that form is Sri Ramakrishna, that form is Jesus, that form is Krishna, that form is Shiva. So different forms come. Swami Vivekananda also says, as he says, I am the way. Swami Vivekananda says in the present time, if you want to understand the Vedanta and the Gita and the scriptures, you have to go through Sri Ramakrishna. Without going through the life of Sri Ramakrishna, you cannot understand Vedas and Vedanta. Why does he say that? It is not that Sri Ramakrishna alone. But for the people in the present time, we find that whatever is written in the scriptures, we have to always understand. If we say only Sri Ramakrishna, or only Jesus, or only Krishna, as some people try to explain, in the Gita, Sri Krishna says, if you follow me, man manapu mad bhakto madhyati maam namaskuru maame vishyasi yuktaivam pratijane priyosime. Be devoted to me, sacrifice everything to me, work for me, and I will take your care. People say, it is only Krishna. If you worship other persons, you may not go. Nobody says that. But Sri Krishna said, so you have to worship Krishna. No other gods, no other deities, no other faith. You have to worship Krishna because Krishna says, I am the way. So that will be seeing the thing in a very dogmatic way, not the right understanding. Krishna there says, in his complete identification with God, I am the way, manmana bhava, be of mind, devote your mind to me. Be my devotee means be a devotee of God. Give your whole mind to me means give to God in any form. To Jesus, to Krishna, to Shiva, to Kali, to Ramakrishna, doesn't matter at all. It is the same thing. Here also, the Jesus says that when he said, I am the way, we have to understand in that way that it is the Jesus saying at that time to his disciples, and the people who are there, they have no other person to see. They don't know about any other thing. So if they follow Jesus, if they make the Jesus as the way, he will take him to the highest bliss. And what is the highest bliss that Jesus could take or God could take? That is being freedom. So he will give life eternal because he is life. And he will give freedom from bondage of ignorance and fear of death. He'll free one fear from all fears, including fear of death and all ignorance, which makes us miserable. The reason, the cause of misery in this world is ignorance. Because we are ignorant, every misery that we face is the reason is ignorance. We are ignorant of our own nature, we are ignorant of the things that happen in the world. All this ignorance creates the problem, strife, conflict and misery. It brings suffering. If we could remove ignorance, there is no suffering in the world at all. People say, oh, devotees of God, God said holy men, they do good, they don't suffer. But I find that so many good persons, they suffer so much. But suffering physically or the things that happen in the world to common people, that may happen to them. But the way they react to that is quite different. It's not suffering from them at all. We see this as suffering. Sri Ramakrishna gives one nice example. He said that one person was a woodcutter and suddenly he had a vision of God. So he was full of joy, he had a lot of knowledge came and he understood that God is the reality. He was in that joy. But next day what he will do? He will again go to the forest and do the labor, carry the weight and then sell the thing. Thing will not continue. There was a clerk, he said, the clerk suddenly realized, practicing a spiritual person, he realized God. He realized the truth. He knew that there is a bliss, but what will happen after realization? He will go on doing the work of the clerk. So all the problems, the people complaining, people misbehaving, people having all this this friction in the world will be there. But after God realization, the person's reaction The crowd's reaction to the people will be totally different. People will try to behave in the same way, try to insult him, but he will not feel insulted. Try to complain against him, he will not feel any fear of complaints. So he is free from fear, free from the sense that he is being insulted. He is always in happiness. His all miseries are gone. For him, he knows. See, situations are same, but his reaction is different. Why did this change happen? Because of knowledge. That God is the reality and things happen according to the nature of the people. So this knowledge removes all ignorance, and with ignorance is removed all misery and suffering of life. So here, for that, we have to proceed. That's why they say this way is a very important thing. And this God's incarnation coming, the most important word of God's advent, whether you call it sending the Son of God, whether you call it sending the prophet, whether you call God himself coming, the most important function of God is the working, like the way. So that the human beings, what is the way? If you are on the right way, you are sure to reach the goal, because you are walking. The way means you have to walk, you have to proceed, you have to drive, otherwise you may not reach. The God has come, or sent one his son, or sent his prophet. Now he has the message for you, he has the way that, there is a way that you can walk to him. But walking we have to do. That is there. So if we don't walk or drive, we are not going to reach the goal. But if you are on the right way, if you have decided to follow the path shown by these God's messengers, then we are sure to reach the goal, that is the supreme place. That will be, you call it heaven, you call it paradise, you call it Nirvana, you call it the Brahmajnana. It is the different languages saying, but it's all is cessation of misery and experience of supreme bliss. That is the goal. And what is the way? What is the path? Path is to follow the teachings and life of these great persons, life of Christ. So great. So wonderful this life, Swami Vivekananda says that if I was alive during Christ's time, I would wash his feet, not with my tears, but with the blood of my heart. So much of love Swami Vivekananda had for Christ. And how Sri Ramakrishna had the vision of Jesus in this image. So this all shows that the Christ, the love of Christ, all absorbed and was there in all them, they had that thing. And we read in the reading today how these people who are not Catholic, who are not Christians, but they had so much of love for Christ, that one who followed the Christ, who represents the Christian world, and he came, the pontiff, the John Pope Paul, how people came to greet him, that he himself was surprised to see, and he praised the Indian ethos, the culture that grew, who can accept all religions and who can find and absorb the good things coming from any other faith, any other person. And to that, to make that, one needs to make the whole humanity, the whole world as our home. Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, that has been the traditional theory of India. The whole world is our home, our family. The whole world is our family. So if one person is great and holy in Arabia or in Israel or where, that is also our family. So whatever we could gain from them for the good of our own life, we will gain. It's not alien. No question of alien. This alien religion, this alien country, this alien person, that concept doesn't arise at all. Jesus becomes our own person. So that's why somebody representing the big the Jesus, when he comes, people come to welcome him. So this becoming the way, when Jesus is the way, when Jesus says to the people who are in front of him. But for us to understand, yes, Jesus is the way for those, but for others who don't follow Jesus, maybe Ramakrishna is the way, but maybe the Muhammad's teaching is the way. Maybe Guru Nanak is the way, but all this the way are true. And all these are ways, various ways, and all those ways will take you to that supreme state. That's why this Swami Vivekananda, when he came, he recited from Gita, and also from Shiva Mahimna Stotra. And that says, Ruchi naam vaichitriyat rijukutila nana patajusham nidam eko gamyas tvamasi payasam aranavaiva. Like the different rivers coursing through different way, different paths. Some are short and going flow fast, some are more curved and longer, crooked. But all those are leading to you, that payasam aranava, that whole body of, big body of water. As they are going, O Lord, all the people who worship according to their nature, different path that they take, all they are going to the same goal, I know that. That's why whatever path we take doesn't matter. All path will lead to there. And another person taking different path is also our co-traveler. We have the same goal. We are the members of the same family. So Godspeed to you. We take your path and proceed further. Proceed ahead. And we will meet there finally. That is the spirit of Indian culture, where we say, yes, Jesus is, to say grammatically, is a way, Sri Ramakrishna is a way, Sri Krishna is a way, so everyone is way. But if they say, I am the way, they have to say that time, because to the persons who are in front of them, those are the people, they have to follow them. The Jesus comes at the time, in that place, so that they follow Him and Him alone. So that becomes the incarnation for that time, of that place. And that's why those followed Jesus and they went to blessedness. Now what about now? Jesus was the way that time. Is not the way now. He's only a way. Jesus is the way for the people who like to follow His teachings. For others, maybe other person is the way, but there is no conflict at all in different ways. That is the thing. That's what Sri Ramakrishna said. Whatever you want to follow, whether you want to follow the teachings of Sri Krishna, as making Sri Krishna as your chosen ideal, or Mother Kali as your chosen ideal, or bravery, motherly love, and fearlessness in all the sorts of... What is Mother Kali represents? What is the difference between Kali and Krishna? Krishna is all sweetness. Kali is all bravery and trying to find God in all difficult times. Like today, you see. Today was so difficult, driving was difficult, slippery, all this warning coming, don't drive, stay home. Many places there is no electricity. But to be able to even adjust with this, to be not be daunted by these situations, is the worship of Mother Kali. That's where Mother Kali stands. Swami Vivekananda says, those who can, who dare to hug the form of death. Death is nothing, life is nothing. I am eternal, what is this death? So to be aware of that, then he says, who can dare to hug the form of death? To him the mother comes. But that is the manifestation of Divine Mother. Bravery, fearlessness, nothing being bogged down. Then the spirit of Divine Mother comes. And the sweetness, beauty, then that like Krishna comes. But there is no difference between these. That the beauty, sweetness, good times, spring, that is also God's manifestation. The ice storm, the snow storm, white wash, the cold, this is also the God's manifestation. One who can take both is a real devotee. And if we want to be always happy, if you want to be really a person of knowledge, free from miseries, we need to accept all these different situations. Good times, difficult times, bad times. Welcome. They all come and go. So they should not be able to just change us and make us sad. So that's why these holy persons, this person who are not holy, even anyone who has a positive attitude, anyone who is a little pure, anyone who can accept everything and everyone, this all comes together. Accepting every situation, one who can do that, that person will start accepting every person also. Sometimes you cannot do that. With this person I like and that person I dislike. This thing, this liking thing has to go away slowly. Everything we can like. And those person who become more pure, more devoted to God, who really follow the way, what Holy Mother says, that's what we find. Holy Mother is the way. You see, when she says, why are you troubled with the difficult times? Every difficulty just passes through. Just have patience to bear that. It's like, and gives the example, like the water flowing under the breeze. Water is coming, breeze, it passes. So like that are the difficult times. Don't be afraid of the difficult times. So they are the way to give us strength. The Jesus is the way. The beautiful, wonderful life of Jesus, His purity, His renunciation, His detachment, everything is so much inspiring to everyone. Swami Vivekananda, when he was a wandering monk in India, he used to have two books. One was the Gita, who inspired him. Another was the Imitation of Christ, that he always read, where is nothing but the devotion and surrender to Jesus Christ. Ramakrishna Mission, when Swami Vivekananda inspired people, inspired his brother disciples to become monks, renounce the world. They were young people, all these 18, 19, 20 years, and they were very loved by their parents. And when Swami Vivekananda inspired them, and what was the inspiration? It was Jesus Christ. He didn't talk about Sri Ramakrishna's wonderful renunciation. He didn't talk about Buddha's renunciation. He talked about Jesus' renunciation of Jesus Christ. So Jesus' life is very inspiring. That is the way that, that Jesus says, I am the way. What I have shown through my life, if we understand this, and if we can practice some of them, you will reach the blessed state. You will reach the ultimate goal. Your life will change. At the time of death, you will not be afraid. You will know that you are going to at the Father's mansion. The God has made, there is place for me. There is light after this. So death time also, you go on smiling and happy. You live happily in the life, difficulties, problems, insults coming. No care. I don't care. I don't care. Nothing that touches me. I can just avoid these things. I can remain in such a way that nothing wrong, negative touches me. And when this body is to be given up, I go laughing. I know that there is a place for me. I have been going through the way shown by all these great holy persons who have come for this. So, to find the way, God has to come for the human beings as human being. That God can come in any form, any form. Hindus have the 10 different kinds of incarnations, right? Starting from fish. Fish is a god. God came in the form of fish. God came in the form of tortoise. God came in the form of boar. God came in the form of half lion, half human being. God came in the form of a dark man. After that, the full man started coming in Parashurama, Rama, Krishna. And then Buddha, and then there will be one coming, Kalki. But those are all the ways, they all can guide us to go to the blessedness. And these are the 10 traditional beings said, but God comes more than that way. There are not only 10. So God came in Jesus, God comes in much of God is manifested in Guru Nanak, God is manifested in all great Shankaracharya, God is manifested in Vivekananda, God is manifested in Sri Ramakrishna. So all these are the ways, if we follow them and walk with them, we will reach the goal. And while walking, so difficult to walk, how to walk, the Bhakti Ramakrishna said, oh, be, give up your ego, be devoted. Holy Mother says, love all, don't find your fault. And it's so difficult, how to not find others, don't find others' fault. How to not find fault? The people I find are very crazy, very different. So it's how to practice this. But if you go on the way, trying to follow them, they will hold our hand And they will difficult path, they will make us cross. Just we need to start following the path with the intention that we have to reach the goal. We have to find. If we are on this path, we will reach the highest thing that this life can give. Human life is very rarely God. Some say it is the only one, once in lifetime you get. Means lifetime means once in eternity. No more you are going to be human. Hindus are very liberal to say, no, you will be human being again, it will be recycled. But this human life, they also say, very precious. As others say, this only one. Those who say there may be other human life, they say it's very rare though, they say. They also say it's very rare. In 8400,000 lives after that, you get one human life. And this is the time where you can make yourself better. Others you can't have. You have rationality, you have more emotion, you have more power. And that's why utilize this time. Get the one guide and walk the way that will lead you to your highest good. So, what is the way? Jesus is the way.